Welcome back. It's time for our parent-to-parent segment. The PSAT is coming up in October, and if your teen scores well enough, they can get the golden ticket to pay for college. Here now from Potential Magazine, this is Potential right here. Publisher Pam Mashburn is here, and from Prattville Christian Academy, we have Mary Virginia Harper, or Ms. Harper, to her students. So it's great to have both of you here with us. When I was in school, and this was a gazillion years ago,
I think I was with you in there. Yeah.
Dinosaurs are roaming campus. Okay, anyway, but we always heard ACT, ACT. Why take the PSAT?
Right, because and it's still ACT everything here now. Mm-hmm. Well, so the PSAT, it's like a pre to the SAT, but the difference is that the PSAT is also can qualify you as a National Merit Scholar. And mm-hmm. I know everybody's heard that term before, National Merit Scholar. And I'm going to let Ms. Harper talk about that, but I do want to mention that the scholarship opportunities for scoring well on the PSAT are huge.
Well, that's why you take it.
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly why you take it.
It is your ticket to it. And, you know, like, for instance, at the University of Alabama, the highest scholarship you can get is a presidential, and it includes full tuition. Mm-hmm. But if you're a National Merit Scholar, you actually get full tuition for 5 years, so you could go to graduate school mm-hmm. if you want. And then you also get like a book stipend, and you get a year of campus housing. So you really are treated much more royally as a National Merit Scholar, and not even to mention some of those other outside company scholarships that you can
get. Well, that is quite an mm-hmm. accomplishment to make that kind of score on that test and, you know, have that kind of certification. Yeah. And you know all too well what that means because you were a scholar, right?
Yes, ma'am. I graduated back in 2012, and I was fortunate to be able to be considered a National Merit finalist. And that did afford me a lot of great scholarship opportunities that otherwise wouldn't have been open to me. So I just want to make sure everybody's aware of what this test could do for them.
So where'd you go to school?
I went to Lamp High School here in town, and mm-hmm. then I went to Vanderbilt for college.
Okay, so did they push that at Lamp?
Yes, absolutely. We were very well informed. We also took the practice PSAT as sophomores, so we had the opportunity to actually take it a year before it counted for us as juniors. So that was definitely very helpful to us to be able to have that practice round and to know that it was important while we were taking it.
Oh, but that not would take every, so much of the stress out of worrying mm-hmm. about how to pay for
oh, yeah.
for college.
But
yes,
you know what?
Absolutely.
A lot of schools make it optional. I mean, it's something mm-hmm. that, so if you're a parent out there, make sure that your child is signing up for it as a sophomore and mm-hmm. as a junior, because it's optional and they don't force the kids to take it. So.
Right. Some schools it's not optional at and everybody just takes it automatically, especially mm-hmm. juniors. But some schools, yes, you absolutely do have to sign up through your school counselor to register for it.
So how do we get our kids ready for a test like that?
As with any test, you want to take a practice test first to get a starting baseline score to work from. There are two free online practice tests for the PSAT at the website provided down at the, I think we're going to put that on screen at some point. The College Board, the company that publishes the PSAT, does offer two free online practice tests that you can print out and take from scratch. I would suggest probably taking that first practice test as a baseline to know what you need to study, and then studying, you know, for the next 2 or 3 weeks, and then retaking a second practice test under timed conditions, of course, so you're getting the actual effect of taking the full-length test.
What are you tested on PSATs?
The PSAT is really designed to measure critical thinking skills. There are two overall sections. The first section is evidence-based reading and writing. So that one, you're going to have reading passages that you have to answer questions on, and then you also have a section where you have to correct grammatical mistakes in someone else's writing. Both of those are multiple choice sections. Then you have a math section that's divided into two portions, calculator and no calculator. And that test actually tests kind of your critical thinking, problem solving skills as well.
So if people are out there watching and they're wondering if their child has even been exposed to this or talked to their counselor about this already, is that where they should go first off, is talk to
Absolutely.
Their counselor?
Yes, your high school counselor is probably the best person to ask for resources or practice materials or any registration questions you may have, because they're the one who will be your liaison with the PSAT.
Right, okay. And October 11th is the date.
October 11th.
That's what
yes,
is being
that's
given
the date for the
statewide.
Test. And it's important to note, with the ACT, you can retake it and your top score is the right. one that colleges take.
Right.
With the PSAT, this is the one and done test. It only counts for juniors and it's only given on October 11th, and that is the only one that'll count for you. So you can't just retake it if you don't get the score you want. This is your only chance.
Okay, you've heard it from someone who's taken it, done well, and went on to college and now is teaching at Prattville Christian Academy.
Yeah.
And you said you graduated in 2012?
I did.
I know. She's so smart.
She's a baby.
She is a baby.
Yes, she is. And we know that you're going to go on to do even bigger and better things. We're so happy to have you here, Mary Virginia, and you too, of course.
Oh, thanks.
Pam.
That was a little lackluster.
Who is a scholar herself. Don't get it twisted. Okay, and also the publisher of this magazine, if they cannot find a copy, because they do go very, very fast when
yes,
you put
do.
Them out, they can find it online, right?
Right, potentialmagazine.com.
Don't give me a hard time.
And we have these good experts that help with that. So.
They do. We need all the help we can get. Thank you. It's so good to see you. Thank you so much.
Nice
good information there.